Hey student, so now we are going to start with one of the most important concept of Fourier series, that is nothing but even and odd functions in the interval minus L to L. Now guys, let me ask you a basic question. Now let's say if I have an integration from minus a to a for a function f of x dx, then what is the shortest way to get the answer? So let me tell you that the shortest way is by using the properties of integration. So you must be remember the property of integration, that whenever we get this type of integration, it has two values. One is 0, another is 2 times integration 0 to a f of x dx. So the first answer is accepted if f of x is even and its value is 0 if f of x is odd. So guys, this is the way to get the answer in minimum number of steps. Now guys, so this formula, whatever I've just explained you, or this property which I've explained you, we can use this same property while finding the Fourier series in the range negative L to L. So always remember, whenever you get a range or interval as minus L to L in Fourier series, your first task is to check whether the given function f of x is even or odd. Because if you are getting that function as even or odd, then guys, let me tell you that this is the fastest way to get the Fourier series, and that will minimize your work as well. So I'll prove it, that how it minimizes your work. And let's say if the given function is neither even nor odd, then you don't have any option. You have to find out a naught, an, and bn to get the Fourier series. So now let's see that if the given function is even or if the given function is odd, what happens and how can we get answer in minimum number of steps. So here, for that, what I'm doing is I'm assuming that the given function f of x is even. So case number one, or a, I will say, let's say f of x is even function. Now let's do the integration for a naught, a and b, and let's check what will be the formula to get the Fourier series in case of even function. So guys, what is the formula for a naught? So the general formula to get a naught is 1 upon 2l negative l to l f of x dx. So guys, as we are saying, or as we are assuming here, that f of x is even, so this is the even function. So whenever f of x is even function, we will use the first result, that is it will be 2 times 0 to l. Now guys, it was minus a to a, but in our question it is minus l to l, so that will become 0 to l f of x dx. So 2 times, so 2 and 2 will be cancelled, and guys, the answer will be a naught equal to 1 upon l integration 0 to l f of x dx. So this is the formula that we will use to find out a naught if f of x is even function in the interval negative l to l. Similarly, let's find out a n. So a n is nothing but 1 by l negative l to l f of x cos of n pi x upon l dx. So this is the formula. Now here we have assumed that f of x is even. So guys, this first function is even, and we all know that cos is universal even function. So it means we got two functions which are even. So let me tell you a property, that even multiplied by even is also even. So it means the resultant function is also even. So if it is even, then again we are gonna use the first result. So by the property of even function, we will get answer as 2 times, so 1 upon l is there, so that will become 2 upon l integration from 0 to l, because it becomes 0 to a, and function as it is, that is f of x cos of n pi x upon l dx. Now let's find out bn. So bn is 1 by l negative l to l f of x sine of n pi x upon l dx. Now guys, we have assumed that f of x is even and sine is universal odd function. So let me tell you that even into odd is odd. So it means the resultant function is odd, and if the given function is odd, the answer of integration is zero, and therefore guys, the answer will be straightforward zero. It means we don't have to evaluate bn, bn will be zero directly. So guys, it means we just got the value of a naught and an, and bn is straightforward zero. So whenever f of x is even, just see, we don't have to find out bn itself, we just have to find out a naught and an and find out the Fourier series. So this is what the formula for f of x equal to even. So Fourier series for even function is given by f of x equal to a naught plus summation n equal to 1 to infinity a n cos of n pi x upon l. And the reason is, since bn is 0. So if bn is 0, we will get a naught and a n. So guys, this is what the Fourier series. Now let's come back to the second case. So in the second case, we will assume that f of x is an odd function. So if f of x is an odd function, let's see what happens. So what is the formula for a naught? So a naught is generally given by 1 upon 2l integration from negative l to positive l f of x dx. Now guys, we are assuming that f of x is odd function. If it is odd function, then integration over minus l to l for odd function is equal to 0. So a naught is 0, straightforward. Next, let's find out an. So an is given by the formula 1 upon l integration negative l to l f of x cos of n pi x upon l dx. Now here we have assumed f of x as odd function and cos is universal even. So odd into even is odd. So the resultant function is odd, and the integration over minus l to l is equal to 0 by the properties of definite integration. So guys, it means an is also 0. So we just have to find out bn. So bn is 1 upon l integration negative l to positive l f of x sine of n pi x upon l. Now guys, here we assumed f of x as odd, sine is universal odd. So odd into odd is even, and therefore we will use the property of even function, which is 2 times. So that will become 2 by l, because 1 by l is outside. So 2 times integration 0 to l, range will be divided into 2 parts or half. Then f of x into sine of n pi x by l dx. So guys, it means in case of odd function, if we find the Fourier series, then that Fourier series will have only one component, that is bn. And therefore, the Fourier series f of x is given by summation n is from 1 to infinity bn sine of n pi x by l in case if f of x is odd. And therefore, here we'll say, since a naught equals to 0 and an is equal to 0. So henceforth, whenever we find any function as odd function, and let's say if we want to find out the Fourier series for that odd function, I'm going to use this result, and I'll be finding that Fourier coefficient, that is bn, by using this formula. So I'm sure that you understood how and why to use the formula of a naught, an, and bn. And in the next video, we are going to solve the numerical based on even and odd function. Thank you very much, guys.